Abbas bhai kept saying kamal hai to everything. kamal hai. And then Bipasha came to set. He said, Bipasha, dress kamal hai, kamal dress. And I realized this is all he's going to say. I remember Salman saying, Sooraj, you think you're going to give a hat trick this time? It's quite rare. And I thought, God, who talks to him like that? You know, I mean, and all of us are like...
But you work with some crazy directors in the sense of their own idiosyncrasies, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's like, say, how different is it to work with Abbas Mustan from Sooraj Barjatya?
Well, Abbas Mustan, it took me a while to figure out who's doing the talking, because Mustan bhai and I got along. Because the first thing he shot with me, I remember when he said, camera aise aega, aur paise ka close-up leke na, phir hero pe aane ka aisa. So I thought, yo, paisa ka close-up and all this is going to be fab, this movie. And Abbas bhai kept saying kamal hai to everything. Everything. Kaise kamal hai. And then Bipasha came to set. He said, Bipasha, dress kamal hai, dress. And I realized this is all he's going to say. You know, so that's all I got from him. But Hussain bhai was an editor. He's the third brother who's like unsung as much. One of the best editors in the industry. He contributed probably the most to films like Race and stuff, where he'd say things like, you know, don't look at him, just say the line and just grab him and bring him back, but don't look, whatever. They'd start shooting at about 10 in the morning, easy peasy. About 5, 6 in the evening, they say, I think we're done. And I'd be like, I love you guys, this is just the easiest shoot
because
ever.
They hate shooting at nights, apparently.
Yeah.
They just won't.
They said, can't do it.
Right.
You know, and then Akshay Khanna told me, he said, you're behaving like a star with them. I said, what do you mean? I'm not behaving like a star. He said, no, you're not hugging them enough. So I said, what do you mean, yaar? So he said, you go and see them and hang out and give them more love, you know, I'm telling you. So I said, okay. And I went tooling off to their room in the hotel Hilton in South Africa. And I saw this thing where there was this white sheet on the floor of the hotel room. And they were sitting on it and they had their whiskey and their peanuts. And they were all sitting there and they said, you know, come and join us. So I sat there for a bit and then I said, you know, and we had a chat and they said, listen, you don't have to sit with us. You don't have to hug us. You don't have to do anything. Just turn up and do your bit. You know, we don't expect anything from you. And that was a great relief. And we got along really well after that. And Suraji, I remember Salman saying when he's doing his makeup, because we were all like, this is the biggest film in India when we did Hum Saath Saath.
Right.
After Hum Aapke Hain.
Yeah, exactly.
Everyone's like, I remember the amount of people that came to see him on the set and touched his feet, you know, everyone from the top heroine to struggling actresses. They all trooped in, Suraji, you know, and with their most charming and I thought, man, I want
to
be like,
just to say hi.
Like, just to say hi and any chance of the next movie.
Sure.
And, you know, hello.
Hum Aapke Hain, right?
And all hitting it like in the most charming way. Right. I remember Rekha ji coming to see him.
Oh, wow.
Like how senior, you know. Wow. So that's like power. And then distributors throwing themselves at their feet on the set saying, when's your film coming? My theatre's, you know, we're running out of money. It's like a drought out there. We're waiting for something. Please, guys. They were like the princes of the film industry in that sense. I remember Salman saying, Sooraj, you think you're going to give a hat trick this time? It's quite rare. And I thought, God, who talks to him like that? You know, I mean, and all of us are like revering him. And here this comment came, I remember.
But that way you've seen like series, you could do a film.
It was like the difference between them. One was like Hindu family, Amar Chitra Katha meets social, like the ultimate in family bonding culture. And it's like an epic happening, it's like a version of the Ramayan.
The whole family itself.
Huh. Right. And the what they're shooting.
Right.
And that atmosphere. And the other one is, you know, brother sleeping with sister and I don't know what's happening. Some kind of incestuous pervy, which is actually great for our country that, you know, both films can be hits.
Right.
So it's not actually as judgmental as people make out, right? I think you have to offset one with the other.
Sure.
They're different sides of a coin, right? Abbas Mustan and the Rajis.
I can't imagine Sooraj Barjatya and the brothers sitting on the floor with booze. And
no.
Chakna
no.
In the center. No, right?
No, but definitely around a table.
Yeah.
Or, you know, eating together. I don't think there's any drinking.
Impossible.
There. No, impossible.
As a producer, you took some steps that people would not usually. Like you went to, say, a zombie comedy.
Yeah.
This is even before we made a zombie film in India.
Yeah.
you were doing a take on a zombie film, yeah. Right? Is that again confidence? That or is this something that you want to watch?
It's not exactly. It is, I guess. I don't know if it's confidence or if it's like. I mean, it just seems like a really good idea, and it seems like it'll be entertaining. Right. And I don't think I am a great producer, because what I love and what I like might not be everybody's cup of tea. And I don't know. A great producer should be able to tell you, okay, this is a joke, as in this is a four-line. Amusing little anecdote. It's not a film.
Right.
Or this is a film. This is a short story. This is a book. He can like suss out different mediums. And within film also, he should be able to tell you at what budget that story should be made. You know, he said, there's a really nice idea, Mike, but if we can do this in 10 crores, it'd be great and take so and so. Or, you know, dude, what you've got is like a 100 crore movie.
Right.
Let's spend 100. Let's take the top star of the country, because this is huge, man.
Right.
So that ability, I don't
to
think
to read
I
a
have.
Script and to be able to see that on
where
screen.
It belongs.
Right.
No. Not right. To read the script and see it on screen. Right. That we all do.
Sure.
But to read the script and to realize how to...
To bracket it.
Yes. And in which, how much money to make it.
Sure.
And who should make it. Right. And who should act in it.
Right.
So that...
And is that something you learned along the way?
I'm saying I can't do it.
Okay.
You know,
the great is that producer. Something you learned about yourself along the way?
Well, yeah, but I've always been like that. I mean, my taste is not, you know, the kind of films I would really like to do. Once in a while, there'll be, and this is what we can, there is a Venn diagram overlap of what I like and what everyone would like. So like Bhoot Police, which I think is a horror comedy, which is actually really, really funny. At least I think it's really, really funny. I hope does that. So sometimes, you know, when Lal Kaptan is offered to you, you say, you talk about freedom. I'm not even free to say no. Mm-hmm. I have to say yes because of the kind of cinematic upbringing I've got. Because I've revered Clint Eastwood in the dollar films. Of course, this is not a copy of that. Mm-hmm. But it is a Western, and a Western is basically this kind of lone swordsman, very like, you know, Yojimbo kind of, but made with the colors and the kind of Indian setting of what William Dalrymple calls the anarchy, you know, that whole time when things are shifting, really dangerous kind of desert, it's wilder than the Wild West. So it's like you can't say no to it. So in that sense, there are certain subjects that I'd really want to do. I don't know.
I'm sure you really wanted to do Agent Vinod.
I did.
I mean, that's why you
that might have been a bit more vain than this, though.
Sure.
Agent Vinod might have been
sure.
Vain. It should have been I made a mistake.
Okay.
And it's so easy to make mistakes. Like, I read history, and people with hindsight are so dismissive. They say, oh, you know, Napoleon made these mistakes. But I'm like, when you're actually there, right. It just seems like.
Right. Those are the variables in front of you.
It's so easy to make a mistake. Right. But I just thought, you know, Jack Bauer from 24 or Agent. Why not an Indian agent, Vinod? But I think a mistake we made, apart from a complicated script or whatever, was there should have been an Indian character. This was a guy who was looking a little too much at the West with his dinner jacket and his little suaveness.
Right.
He should have been like a ballpoint pen, chashma wearing.
Like the family man. I don't know if you've
I haven't
had
seen
a
it,
but
I've heard it's fab.
Pretty good.
It's pretty good,
yeah.
It's great.
Yeah.
Raj DK again. But it should have been something more desi. My agent Vinod.
Did you at some point decide to shell the film during its making? Like you just felt it was going out of hand?
No. Again, Dinesh Vijan produced, and he's very good at balancing this stuff. So what happened was, we were shooting in some heritage site and doing this killer action sequence with machine guns and everything. And we needed to blow some stuff up, you know. So we said, okay, there's a couple of these structures, beautiful medieval temple structures.
No,
of course not. So we said, okay, there they are. And 100 yards to the right, let's build replicas.
Right.
So it's part of the same complex. Right. And we blow them up, you know.
Yeah.
So these guys were nuts. They said, you're blowing up the complex. We said, no, we're blowing up what we've put up.
Huh.
So then they stopped shooting. And then we had to redo things. And something got cancelled. And there was a lot of pressure like that to scrap what we were doing. But we readjusted and kind of shot another sequence somewhere else and blah, blah, blah. It was tough to do, but we managed it. We weren't really thinking of shelving it ever.
I've always wanted to ask you, why did you name your company Illuminati?
Well,
I mean,
you know,
does that have anything to do with the secret society governs the world?
It's
the conspiracy
theory. There was just something about illumination and light and about the fact that, yeah, the Illuminati were a group of people, including, you know, Isaac Newton, etc., who questioned the authority of the church and talked about the importance of secular knowledge. Mm. So that struggle of just wanting to tell the truth and not be oppressed. Right. So it's a kind of slightly rebellious, but ultimately it's like a projector of light, like Illuminati is to illuminate. And, right. And so that's what a film projector does. And I think Johnny Depp had a production company called Nihil Infinitum or something. Nothing's impossible. Or something. So I just thought a cool, and I used to really look up to him when I was that age. He's been replaced by Tom Hardy now as my kind of image. So that's why. That's what Illuminati is.
And why did you guys, you and Dinesh, why did you guys like...
Part ways? Well, basically because Dinesh Vijayan is on his way to doing what he wants, which is to be, you know, a very big film producer. Right. And what I wanted was someone who's going to run my production company and do stuff for me.
Right.
But he wants to, you know, which is fair. That's how it starts out, and people, that's why people usually leave.
Sure.
To do it on their own, you know? That's right. The only reason. I mean, I don't really want to make films for 20 other people. I don't mind, maybe, but I don't.
I mean, you were, right? In Cocktail, you were offering the lead role to other people.
We did.
Yeah.
I only stepped into Cocktail because nobody wanted to do it. I think Ranbir didn't want to do it. Imran Khan didn't want to do it. So I said, okay, I'll do it. They should remember.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.